Aside the external forces as well as the environment which affect the wind turbine system, another aspect of consideration is the dynamic effects on this wind turbine system, especially when it has to do with damping as well as vibration at a particular frequency. Hi there and welcome to Catchment of Resources. This is part 8 in the series on the use of OpenFast. Here we'll be looking at dynamic consideration in OpenFast and in particular tuned mass damping, TMD, vibration as well as resonance. You can see here this schematic which has been taken from this source where it shows different formulation or a modeling of different masses acting upon the tower, the nacelle and the foundation of a wind turbine system. You can see here the stiffness, the mass as well as the damping factor C. This is just a snapshot of the different forces that actually act on the wind turbine system that keep it in equilibrium according to Newton's second law. Basically, damping has to do with the forces which are opposing the motion of the wind turbine system. For example, if you have wind coming onto the blade, these damping forces actually slow down the effect that is being caused by this wind velocity. So you can see here you have the mass matrix, the damping matrix, the stiffness matrix, as well as all of them equating to external force matrix. So in order to edit files, you're actually looking at the .fst file, Elastodyne, Hadrodyne, Servodyne and Subdyne. Within Servodyne, you have actually the structural control module, which is STC. This is the segment where you actually have, previously it was termed the TMD, the tuned mass damping area, but here you now have the control modules which are used for damping in different parts of the structure. In this video, you can see how each of these different files, the different parameters where you need to edit them, you can see here for the .fst file. And when you come to another file, you can actually come down to Elastodyne, and in Elastodyne you see some requirements for data to be input for the input file. You can see here 1% of damping ratio. When you're talking about Elastodyne, we are referencing the rotor system along with the blades, the kind of parameters you need to input. So depending on the kind of equipment in terms of what you have in your establishment or equipment which you have seen in the past, it's possible to know which kind of values are going to be used in updating the variables in OpenFast. Typically on equipment manual and datasheet, you also find some information such as probably the rotor parameters like the velocity or the rotation speed, the mass and other information. Some of this information you also get it during the analysis in OpenFast, but you know OpenFast optimizes all the values and puts them all together. TMD, which is tuned mass damping, has been changed in OpenFast 3.0 and newer versions to STC, which is actually the structural control module, and it's within Servodyne. So within Servodyne, you actually do the editing, and in some cases you get to request for files. So then you need to understand what kind of information is required in this STC. Since we have already isolated the damping parameters, so with these parameters, it's easier to actually make an inquiry on the platform of OpenFast to understand what you actually need. Then when it comes to natural frequency of an object, every object has its own natural frequency, and you can see from this equation how to estimate it. Where you have the stiffness, you have the mass of the object, and from there you get this frequency. It's easiest for when an applied force is made for this object to move within this frequency. So when you have different frequencies for different objects in the wind turbine system, the standard typically is for the rotor to be acknowledged as 1P. So when you are referencing this as 1P, depending on the number of blades of the wind turbine system, this has been taken from Vander, Tempo and Molena, this schematic, so it's actually borrowed from them. Once the rotor system is taken as 1P, so whatever the frequency is stands as 1, and then when you have the wind turbine blades, assuming you have 3 wind turbine blades, if you multiply by the frequency of the rotor system, you have about 1.11 Hz. And when you talk about the other external forces or frequencies such as those from the ocean wave or gust wind, you're talking about 0.04 to 0.1 Hz. So in either case, you are going to target other members of the wind turbine system to either fall within any of this band or beyond it or below it. Otherwise, you are more likely to have a situation where resonance occurs. Thank you for watching this video. This is Catchment of Resources, where we create for better living.